My dear viewers, Assalamu alaikum, may peace be upon you. Greetings, dear viewers. Today, we delve into the Book of Revelation and Sahih al-Bukhari's Hadith, starting with Chapter 6. It's quite lengthy, so I've split it into two parts for easier understanding. Let's embark on this journey together. I seek Allah's protection from the rejected Satan devil. In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful. Chapter 6. Narrated Abdullah ben Abbas, Abu Sufyan ben Harb, informed me that Heraclius had sent a messenger to him while he had been accompanying a caravan from Quraysh. They were merchants doing business in Sham, Syria, Palestine, Lebanon, and Jordan, at the time when Allah's messenger, peace be upon him, had truce with Abu Sufyan and Quraysh, infidels. So Abu Sufyan and his companions went to Heraclius at Ilya, Jerusalem. Heraclius called them in the court, and he had all the senior Roman dignitaries around him. He called for his translator, who, translating Heraclius's question, said to them, "Who amongst you is closely related to that man who claims to be a prophet?" Abu Sufyan replied, "I am the nearest relative to him amongst the group." Heraclius said, "Bring him, Abu Sufyan, close to me, and make his companions stand behind him." Abu Sufyan added, "Heraclius told his translator to tell my companions that he wanted to put some questions to me regarding that man, the prophet, and that if I told a lie, they, my companions, should contradict me." Abu Sufyan added, "By Allah, had I not been afraid of my companions labeling me a liar, I would not have spoken the truth about the prophet." The first question he asked me about him was, "What is his family status amongst you?" I replied, "He belongs to a good noble family amongst us." Heraclius further asked, "Has anybody amongst you ever claimed the same I to be a prophet before him?" I replied, "No." He said, "Was anybody amongst his ancestors a king?" I replied, "No." Heraclius asked, "Do the nobles or the poor follow him?" I replied, "It is the poor who follow him." He said, "Are his followers increasing, decreasing, day by day?" I replied, "They are increasing." He then asked, "Does anybody amongst those who embrace his religion become displeased and renounce the religion afterwards?" I replied, "No." Heraclius said, "Have you ever accused him of telling lies before his claim to be a prophet?" I replied, "No." Heraclius said, "Does he break his promises?" I replied, "No, we are at truce with him, but we do not know what he will do in it." I could not find opportunity to say anything against him, except that. Thank you for tuning in, dear viewers. If you enjoy my content, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the notification bell to receive daily updates. May Allah bless and protect you all, as well as our beloved brothers and sisters in Palestine. Ameen. Take care of yourselves and those around you. Spread happiness. And remember, Chapter 6 of the Hadith series will continue in parts.